are in what I call the Heroes Room, and this room is dedicated to those men and women who have served in the military, and primarily to my son, Marc Alan Lee. He was the first Navy SEAL that was killed in Iraq on August 2nd, 2006, and I'm so, so very proud of him. And I recognize that there is a price for our freedom, and I know firsthand the cost of that, and Marc willingly laid down his life. The day that he died, he was up on the rooftop, and his buddy had been hit severely by shrapnel. The bullet had hit his gun, and he had severe injuries to the head, and they could tell by looking at him that he needed immediate care and immediate attention, and they did not have a medic up on the rooftop with him. And so at that point, Marc stood out in the direct line of fire to be able to get the medic up to the rooftop, and the medic agreed with them. When they got up to the rooftop, they said, we've got to immediately get Ryan out of here. There's no chance for survival. So not once, but a second time, Marc stood up in the direct line of fire all by himself, kind of John Wayne style, and he was a young man who valued other people's lives more important than his own. And they were able to successfully get Ryan down off the rooftop. They had all gone back to the base, which I'm very proud to tell you is named in his honor. It's Camp Marc Lee. And their chief came in and told them they had found where the insurgents are that had just attacked them, and asked the guys if they were up to going back out. And I don't know how they get the strength to do that. God equipped me as a mother and as a nurturer. And they had just seen their buddy, who they think has probably been fatally wounded, wouldn't survive his injuries. And to be able to gather that strength and to go back out and be willing to sacrifice their lives, only God can understand how he designs young men like that. And Mark's name actually means mighty warrior. And he definitely lived up to his name that day. But Marc looked at his chief in the eye and said, "Roger that, let's go get them." So they went back out. They had done house-to-house clearing and cleared the bottom of the building that they were in. And Marc was not an officer, but that day he chose to lead his guys up to the rooftop. And it was at that point that Marc willingly laid down his life. And a lot of people have said to me that the terrorists took your son's life. But nobody took Mark's life. He willingly gave his life. And I was a single mom most of their life, and lots of times they would come to me for answers, and I didn't have the answers. But God had promised to be a father to the fatherless and a husband to the widow. And so my kids would hear me say, "Go ask your daddy." And they knew that that meant to be on their knees, to be in the Word, looking for the answers from their Heavenly Father. So it's no surprise to me that Marc followed in his daddy's footsteps. And he did the same thing and laid down his life, just like Christ did for us. And Marc provided the freedoms for us here on earth that we have as a nation. And I'm so grateful. I recognize those freedoms that we have. And at Memorial Day, we all need to be grateful for what our men and women serving in the military have given to us and the blessings that we have. But the greater blessing that we have is what Christ did for us when he laid down his life for us to have those freedoms for an eternity. And I'm glad to say that Marc today is in heaven with his heavenly Savior, and he's worshiping and praising, and I can't imagine, just like that song says, I can only imagine. But he's there in the presence of our God and Father, who gave everything for us, so that if we believe, we can also do that same thing and be in heaven, just like Marc is today. I'm so very, very proud of him. He is one of my heroes, and that's why I use my voice to speak out in support of our troops, because I understand the sacrifices that they make and that their families make for me, for you, and for this nation. And so this Memorial Day, I'm very grateful for everyone who served in the military so proudly and so honorably. They are my heroes, and I'm very grateful for that.